What's up, Mission City Church? It is good to be with you today. My name is Russell, and I'm the lead pastor here at Mission City. Today's going to be a little bit different. We are concluding our prayer series. Happy Memorial Day weekend as well. I hope you're getting to spend time with your family and enjoy that during this holiday weekend. But a few things about today. So we're ending our prayer series, and instead of having a fifth sermon on prayer, what we're going to do instead is we're going to practice a little bit. And so we're not going to have a sermon or worship or anything like that. Our team in Kansas City, or our church in Kansas City, is actually going through the city and different neighborhoods and little business parks and stuff like that, and apartment buildings. And we're just going to go and pray. We're going to pray for our city. We're going to pray for people. We're going to pray that people come to know Jesus. And it's going to be an incredible time. Now, this could seem really uncomfortable for you, like even to be a part of it. Something like that. But we're encouraging people that are watching online to maybe after you hear this video, turn this off and just go walk around your neighborhood and pray for them. Pray that people, again, would come to know Jesus. Pray that for the believers that are there, that they would be bold. Pray that God would show you something along the way as well. But we're doing that because we want to grow in our ability to in prayer. And one of the things about doing that is learning how to pray, for our city and for our neighbors as well. And so if you're like, well, what do I pray for? So we have a couple of things that would be awesome for you to pray for. The first one is we have our vision statement. There's a verse kind of under it. It comes from 1 Corinthians 2:1. It says, "For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified." And the thought of that is that we want to be about Jesus. We want people to know Jesus. We want people to follow Jesus. And that our message and that your message would be of this beautiful picture of who Jesus is. And what He came to do by dying on a cross and rising again, offering forgiveness for the sins of the world, and also offering life to those who believe in Him. So that's one thing you just pray for, that you know, you would be known for that nothing except Jesus Christ and Him crucified, that people would know nothing except Jesus Christ and Him crucified, and they would live in that power of the resurrection that He's talking about as well. There's a couple of things too that you can pray. There's three R words maybe to help you. First is you can pray that God would reveal something to you. And this could be personal. Like maybe you're in a place where you need God to answer a prayer, or maybe you're in a place where you need God to move in some new ways, or just ignite something new, and maybe God will reveal something to you in that. Also for revelation about your neighborhood. Maybe there's a house or a neighbor that you just want to spend more time praying over. That's good. Like slow down enough, be mindful enough to be aware, to discern maybe what God might be leading you to do as well. The second one, our words we get revealed. The second one is renew. Pray for personal renewal. Pray for societal renewal. Like maybe your neighborhood has some like there's tension there. There's a history there of whatever. Like pray that God would redeem that and renew that as well. And then the third one, so you got reveal, renew, and you have revival. And then ask God would move. Pray this, write this down, Acts 26:18. It says, "To open their eyes so that they may turn from darkness into light, and from the power of Satan to God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and a place among those who are sanctified by faith." That your neighbors who don't know Jesus, who are living in darkness, that they would come to know the person who is light, the person that who is life, the person who is Jesus. And then also pray for the believers, like in this revival, pray for the believers that they would be bold, as it says in Ephesians 6, as the 6:19, it says that for me, that the words may be given to me in opening my mouth boldly to proclaim the mystery of the gospel, that believers in the area would be bold to do that as well. So three things: pray for that God would reveal things to you, maybe in your own life, pray for your personal renewal, and then renewal in your neighborhood, and then pray for revival. Pray that God would move in some mighty ways. Now, again, this might be a little uncomfortable for you. This doesn't have to be 2 hours, 10 hours. You can go for 15 minutes. But we want to care about our neighbors. We want to not just exist for ourselves. We want people to know who Jesus is, and we want them to know we care. If you run into someone on the street and they say, "What are you guys doing?" We're actually walking around just praying over the neighborhood. Can I pray for you? And if they say no, okay, cool. Have a great day. Thanks. But if they say yes, then ask them how you can pray for them and pray for them and care for them. Have compassion for them. I have a friend that talks about, he talks about believers or Christians need to own the lostness of our city. And if we want to own the lostness of our city and realize that we have responsibility and a commission from Jesus to share the gospel and to care for our neighbors in this world, like then it can start with maybe even the simple practice of taking a walk with your family and praying. And so just would encourage you to do that. If you have more questions, you can reach out to russell@missioncitykc.com. We'd love to help you and shepherd you along the way. And maybe make this a regular pattern. Maybe you do it once a month. Maybe you do it once a week. You know, maybe if you walk all the time with your family, maybe do it every day. Just a part of your walk is you have a few places that you stop, or every different weeks it's different because you just stop and pray at different places. Let me pray over this, and then we'll see you next week. Normal service. We'll kick off a series in Ecclesiastes. So Lord Jesus, I just pray over these prayer walks that might be happening all over the country, maybe even in the world. I pray that you would use this time, God, that we would care about our city, that we would own the lostness of our city, that we would love our neighbors, and that we would just pray, God. We'd pray for that you would reveal things to the people walking about maybe things that are going on in the neighborhood or even in their own lives. We would renew them and renew the city around them. And God, that you would bring revival in Kansas City and all across this world. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, have a great week, and we will see you next time.